Yeah, you hearing some of them?
Listen, so as long as I live, I love you. We'll have it all, you look so beautiful in white. And from now to my very last breath, just stay, I'll cherish. You look so beautiful.
It's timeless, my love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word. So as long as I live, I love you.
Tired trying to fill that void, or do you? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we do have the winning donuts to start. Well, my dear Pastor Chen, how are you today?
I am great. I am blessed. We are excited. We are live from inside Isaiah Temple Spiritual Baptist Church in Cuba, Trinidad. This is a church that is 35 years old in ministry, located on Polo Ground Road. We're alive. This is awesome. This is completely awesome.
Are you seeing this?
I'm seeing this.
Oh my God!
I'm totally seeing it. And so we have the first set of the bridal party that just walked down. This is let's see here. I believe that was our Sister Michaela?
Yeah, it looks like that was Sister Michaela. Oh my God, that's awesome. They are awesome. They are looking beautiful. Is this the bride that I'm seeing there?
Is coming up the door there.
Oh my God, that is Sister Carla. I wish that we can hear anything over there. Apparently, they're having audio problems over there. Could we get some audio? Let's see if our camera lady can give us some audio over there. Oh, there we go. Awesome dress. This dress was made by her own seamstress. Just imagine that. Oh my God.
This is a custom design dress made by Jaira. So any people out in Trinidad there, you need a design custom. Jaira is the person to talk to.
Man, this is really, it is awesome. I don't think it can get better than this today. I can imagine that my good brother Kurt is very excited. Oh my goodness.
We spoke to him a little bit earlier, and he was so excited trying to keep calm. I can only imagine what he's feeling right now.
Oh my goodness. I really, really can't imagine. Listen, I can imagine my good brother today is being elated on this day. You know, he is being elated. And there we are. We're actually on camera now. How are you, my sister?
Hey. I'm great. I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're witnessing the live wedding ceremony of the Reverend Kurt, Elliot Gasper, and Carla Bonus as they get ready to become Mr. and Mrs. today. It's good to have you.
Right now what you're seeing is the bride is being escorted by her father, Cecil Bonus, and she's heading to the altar right as we speak.
Oh wow, this is truly a beautiful day in Trinidad and Tobago for the Baptist community.
One thing that I want to mention, because this service is being officiated today by Reverend Mother Claxton, who is the aunt of Preacher Preach, as we lovingly know him and call him, more officially Reverend Kurt.
Oh, there we go. Let's see what's going on over there. I wonder if our camera lady is going to move a little closer for us to see what's happening close up there.
I think that would be great. I'm pretty sure she will be moving in shortly. While they're doing this and the audio is being corrected, I just want to mention that this wedding ceremony should have been officiated by the late His Eminence Patriarch Dr. Julian Stephen, who just recently passed away a few weeks ago. We applaud and encourage this couple who decided to push forward even though the loss happened in the ministry. And so Mother Claxton has taken up the mantle for today's ceremony.
Awesome. We know that the church is in good hands. Hallelujah. Let's sing for them. Hallelujah. You know, while they, here we go. Official.
Why
What a mighty God indeed it is today. What a mighty God.
So the best man that is standing to the right of the groom is Mr. Stephen Alfonso. He's a leading seaman in the Coast Guard. He's called the God of War, coming out from the 45th intake.
Wow. I believe it's my belief that Kurt is also from the 50th battalion over there from the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard. I think he got a good friend there.
Yes.
And there we go. Let's listen to how. I think we observe a minute of silence for the latest eminence patriarch, Julian.
Is going a little bit in and out.
Yeah, we do apologize for the song over there in Trinidad and Tobago. I think we're going to see how best we can see what's going on. There should be no one speaking. Everybody should hold their peace.
That's right. So as you can see, the father giver and the mother giver are standing behind the bride and the groom. The mother giver today is Annette Elliott Phillips, and this is the mother of the groom. And as we mentioned before, the person who escorted Sister Carla down the aisle was her father, Cecil Bonus.
And that is the sister of the one who's conducting officiating the wedding today, the Right Reverend Brother Claxton. We do apologize. I hope that you're not hearing any echo anymore to those of you on YouTube. I want to thank all those congratulates that are coming in on YouTube. Joanne Cummings is sending in her congratulates. Debbie Corsia, yeah. Joanne Cummings. Oh my God, Linda. I think they're exchanging vows right now.
We did get some insight into the ceremony ahead of time. And before the vows are exchanged, there is going to be a special reading of a poem from a Sister Samira Bradshaw. So we're looking forward to hearing that poem. I know that it's a really special poem that is near and dear to the heart of the bride and the groom.
Look. I think Kurt is about to give his vow. It is good to see that they are actually observing COVID protocol over there.
Yeah, that's really, really, really great. You can see even in the audience that they've limited how many people can attend the service. So we are really glad for the opportunity to broadcast it. Although the sound is not 100%, but still being able to see it and witness it is really a special, special occurrence. Whilst they're exchanging vows, and I know that we can't really hear too clearly, I just want to briefly talk about some of the people that are in this bridal party, Bishop. So there were flower girls. There's a Skylar Bain. There's a Michaela Boyce. Let me pause here at Michaela Boyce. She is the adopted daughter of the late patriarch. Amen. And so she's included in this special day as well. And the third flower girl is Nertali Bain.
Right. Yes, it is. And as you see that, if you notice that the maid of honor is Lana Shakawa. I hope I'm not mashing up that name. And the best man, of course, Stephen is there also. Alfonso leading. As you say, he's one of the seamen. He's a seaman coast guard over there. A god of war. Oh my goodness. What a name.
That's the nickname. And he's coming through on the 45th intake.
I think we're going to have the poem going on right here.
Okay.
Again, we do apologize for the song quality in Trinidad over there. We really apologize, but at least we are seeing history in the making here.
Yep, we're witnessing it for sure. I suppose that even after this, if we can perhaps get a copy of that poem, it might be something that we can post
later. Yes, definitely. We can probably pin it on the website.
Also in the bridal party, there is Melissa James that we saw being escorted by Rubaco Mills. And so Sister Melissa is the late patriarch's granddaughter, and her escort, Brother Mills, is the DJ of Insightful Sundays.
So wow. If there are
any Insightful Sundays fans out there, there he was looking very dapper in his
Is this the ring? Woo! Here we go.
Okay.
You know, what's going to happen if he is preach? What are we going to call her? Is she going to be the new evangelist?
I mean, we could just say she's going to be Mrs. Preach. I mean, that might work too. I mean, otherwise it's evangelist evangelize.
we got to have to see what's happening here.
That's the exchange of the rings. He pledged his love.
Yeah, just like the ring has no ending, their love have no ending, you know?
That's the symbolism. That's the symbolism. And of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
And here we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there we have it.
There we have it. There we have it.
You all seen it live here tonight, today actually. First time. Mr. and Mrs.
This is so lovely. We just got some information. The person that read this poem was Sister Samira Bradshaw. We will definitely try to get a copy of that poem for the viewers today. The rings have just been exchanged. Vows have been shared. And we are awaiting to see the next steps in this ceremony. It looks like as though they're about to have them kneel.
I think a family of priests together stays together, so they're going to stand themselves right by praying.
Absolutely. And we see that the stole of Reverend Mother Claxton is being laid upon the bride and groom for a blessing. So Bishop, I know that you've done a number of wedding ceremonies. Typically, what is being said around this time?
Well, she's not pronounced as a blessing upon her from God. You know, this is from the altar in which we say, listen, we have done the man part to say this is what man wants and what he and his newly wife wants. And he says, now, the person who is pronounced as a blessing says, listen, while you want this love, we want God to take you through. So they pronounce the message that God will go in front and lead them and direct them through this path, you know, from henceforth. This is the message here. There we go. There we go, the message. There we go, the crossing of the time.
Yes. And that's symbolic of the statement that we use, what God has joined together, that no man put asunder. So it's a very symbolic moment at this time.
I think this is one of the most sacred moments in the wedding ceremony. Here we go. And here they go, step up as Mr. and Mrs. as they get ready.
And the song that's being played in the background is less high.
And we have that gentleman on trumpet. Oh my goodness. That gentleman you see walking around there, just behind, that is the husband of Reverend Mother Claxton. That's our bearer today, and he's doing a fantastic job by assisting her today. That's Deacon Claxton, who is working his ministry. There we have it. This register will be sent, has already been sent to the Red House. Now the official signing of the minister. This will be it here that they will now become Mr. and Mrs.
Official. Yeah, so the license is typically sent back to the government office. And the couple receives.
Look at that, look at that. He has started doing his husbandly duty, moving the chair for his wife. Oh my goodness.
I love it. Done, Reverend.
I'm taking an example. Look at that, look at that.
You're learning something?
I'm learning something. I'll have to listen. He's reminding me of my old days. I have to step up.
Well, First Lady, you're watching it. Your husband said he's step it up. So.
Yeah, I think my wife is going to hold me to the past of that. We must lead by examples. We must lead by examples.
He's even holding the train. Listen. Reverend Kurt, you are on point today. You're holding the train. Yes, sir.
Listen, I'm seeing a lot of people here. Eva Shante Smith is sending a congratulation. Nancy Alicia Sullivan. Oh my God. Albertina Pastor Richard, all the way from Florida. For Lauderdale is on. Sister Eman. Is this Sister Eman from New York?
Yes, from New York. The candy.
And there we go. Even Mother Valerie Saunders is on today. Look at that.
That's right.
And then we have the two witnesses, the mother giver and the father giver. They are just officially citizens. We are handing them over to each other, and listen, they are no longer our property. Now it belongs to each other in the sight of God and man.
I love it. I just wanna acknowledge Sister Valerie, Mother Valerie Saunders. She said she likes my hat. I dressed up for today's event. Like, this is...
I agree. I can curse about it. We got 120 people viewing this wedding just today.
And you know, being that it is the middle of the day, that's really a blessing. People will be watching after their birthday has been filmed.
Yes, true. I just saw Mother, listen, that is Mother Esther just stepped in there. Sending her congratulations.
I love it.
And even Brother Richard is on today. Brother Richard, all the way, he's back in.
Reverend Mother Claxton is giving the couple some encouraging words, a sermonette of sorts of how to conduct themselves in their married life.
You know, I think this is the best job for the pastor in a wedding, where we get to advise them to warn and to let them know how they ought to walk circumspect, not just before man, but before God, and how they ought to live in togetherness. The Bible tells us, man must love his wife as Christ loved the church. while the wife only has to submit herself to her husband, he has to love. So I pray that they do love here. It's good to have the right. We do have Mother Estella online here with us today, Mother Mary Alexander. Oh my God, they are all in today.
That's great. That's great.
As Bishop Estella.
It looks like also Sister Cherry Ann Joseph has popped in, as well as Sister Donna.
Yes. You heard what the preacher just said. You have just walked in single. You are not going to walk out single. Now you're going to walk in joined together as one. Wow.
I love it.
Oh, and there we go, Mr. and Mrs. Gasper. Wow. Listen, I can't make style of my brother of faith on Friday night no more. I gotta choose something else now.
There you go.
There we go, Mother Gemma Phillip. Mother Leila French is in. She's in a congratulations. Emma Hathaway, also.
Flooding the bride and groom. Well done.
Well done, well done. Awesome job. Awesome job today. Woo. I think she's given not just the minister's warning, but she's given him an anti-warning also.
Oh yeah, he's getting all of it. All of it. All of it.
Look at that, they're about to kiss her, he's about to kiss the bride. I see the mask is being removed. Wow!
Hey, 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 Rev, don't hurt yourself. What?
Listen, this is an official kiss. This is what I call a legal kiss.
He now has a license to kiss freely.
Amen. I believe that. I truly believe that. And there we go. They're starting to get ready to welcome as they get ready to leave the church.
Probably a couple of photos on the way out, but yes. A great photo op for those that are physically there in the church.
I don't know if our camera lady is going to go to the front so we can see them walking out.
I would love to see that. I look at them making their way out. The bells are ringing.
Bells are ringing. Bells are ringing. There she goes. She's going for some blood. Ladies and gentlemen, look at that. By the power and blessing. There we go. Mr. and Mrs. Woohoo! Let's hope the camera lady is going to follow them. Awesome, awesome. And if the camera lady can get in front of them, it would be great.
Yeah, we want to. Let's hope that our camera lady can get out.
All of the church can give us a front view and see what's happening outside. And she followed the bridal party up here. Oh, we even have the teacher, the esteemed lady teacher, Gloria Calvin, that is online. Wow.
Hey, teacher. I love what teacher said. It's a nice setting, but a great parent.
Yes.
Bishop, that's the key. You are so focused on the day, but it's about what happens after.
That's right. Yeah, that's correct. It's what happened after, you know. But you know what's so nice about it? He had you and I to pull up his socks and to give him some good insight. You know, we are not just friends, but we're going to be his good brothers and make sure we do something when it's needed.
When it's needed. That's
and there we go.
Community.
Yes. And there goes us, so our camera lady is going out front with them. There we go. They are going. I think they're going to go to the church hall to eat their butts up shut and curry goat.
Well, now
we're
talking.
Well, I wish I was in Trinidad today just to have stuff. Oh, here we go to the bridal party. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful.
Yep. The Skylar and Michaela and Natalie, Melissa, Nikisha. Then we have Mr. Aaron Mark, Keston Guy, Lana Sakawat.
I think today has long, it has been forthcoming. Listen, it has been really, really forthcoming. Here we go, they are happy. Look at it, the flowers are still throwing petals.
Listen. I love it. They're on flower duty.
Ooh.
They're making sure.
I think they're going up the hill.
I love it. So for those that don't know, Reverend Kirk has been in the Coast Guard for quite some time. As you see, some of his Coast Guard brethren are there supporting him in the bridal party. But he's been a reverend in Isaiah Temple since October 28, 2012. So this is, a long stretch been in ministry. And the bride, she is a businesswoman. She has custom-made designs, a proprietor. She can stand on her own two feet. What a wonderful support to have. What a great blend in this marriage union. So it's really interesting because they met in the church. I guess our Reverend Kurt had his eye on our sister Carla. And now I guess that eye was strong.
So if our camera lady could just go a little closer so we can give our viewers. Thank you very much. And if you could get a little nice. Nice, thank you. Lift your hand up just a little for us so we can see the nice. Thank you very kindly. All right. You know, our camera lady goes to the left, they go to the left, our camera goes to the right, they go to the right. what a joyful day indeed for Isaiah Temple, the Right Reverend Kirk, no stranger to the social media. Today he has become Mr. He was just Kirk, preach. But today we're going to call him Mr. Preach.
Mr. in front. There
yeah.
we go.
Mr. Reverend Kirk. Listen, Reverend Kirk. Listen, look at the bridal party. Look how awesome they look. And he's waving for us. Hi,
Reverend and Mrs.
Reverend and Mrs. Gaspar.
Reverend Gaspar. Yes. There we go.
There we go.
I love it. The end of the bridal party, pulling off a nice khaki colored suit there, and I see some suspenders and some vests. I mean, they've really kind of blended in on the different looks and the different takes of the colors. The colors are blending very nicely. We love how the whole bridal party is looking. The bridesmaids' dresses with the lace and that sort of gold hue, champagne color. They look fantastic.
You know, I often say after a wedding day, after the wedding day, let me say that the rose shouldn't stop coming, the chocolate shouldn't stop coming, the fancy dining shouldn't stop coming. It should continue. It should continue. It shouldn't just stop there. We're just going to transition here, and then we're going to come back to them in a minute. Hi. just to give us a little close-up and see what we look like here. It's truly a blessing indeed for today to see our brother Kurt and his lovely wife tied in knots, as they normally say. How did you feel when you tied in Pastor Jed?
Oh boy. There was a lot of nervousness. I got married in West Africa. And So that is a whole different cultural experience than what we are accustomed to in the Caribbean and even in the United States. I had a dowry paid for me. My husband had to pay through his teeth and his pocket in order to get hitched. And we always laugh about it that even if I said, you know, I don't want to be married anymore, because we went through several times, I have to divorce him several times before I can get away. So
Well, I think Kurt is going to be in it for the long run. I don't know what is the diary he paid, but let me just go back over there so people can see what's really happening. I know they're taking photos. But I can imagine the diary he paid because, you know, Cool Sky, they chirp on all. Listen.
It
doesn't come cheap. I don't care what it is. It doesn't come cheap. You know, I often say, listen. Are you in it for the long haul? Till death do us part. that's what is important. New Bishop Zion Worshipers is in with us today. We want to welcome you. Thank you, Sister Deb Corr is in today. What a time. You know. I don't want to take this opportunity. If anyone would like us to do commentary for us, you feel free to reach out to Pastor Jen or myself. Have a wedding and they would like someone to commentary for them on their wedding. This is one of our services we are offering to the public. This one is our gift to our brother Kurt. It's our first one, and I hope that you really enjoyed it. Pastor Jeff, what do you think about that?
I think it's a great idea. This is really, as somebody put in here, it's the red carpet commentary. We are treating this like spirits or a gala event. And really getting in on here. We did our research prior to. We wanted to make sure we had our stories right and all those good things and add those anecdotes and that everyone has enjoyed the commentary thus far, especially kind of not being able to hear as well because the mic system in Trinidad had some challenges.
I mean, we do apologize for that. But what is so interesting that I'm looking here is now you have a new form of family here. She didn't just lose a son, but she gained a daughter, and he didn't just lose a daughter, but he gained a son. And this is so awesome. This is really, really, really awesome. You know that our family now has now become one great family as they go out and have their own and to come back. You know, Mother Jackie, welcome.
Someone said in the comments here, Bishop, that we have to be in person for their wedding. I am more than happy to be in person for your wedding. We will set up our station in the back of the church and run live commentary right from there. We're more than happy to show up.
Awesome. Anything for the people of God. Anything for the people of God. You know. And here we have the right Reverend Claxton. Yes. You know, listen, not just the Reverend, but Anti-Claxton. You know. Anti-Claxton is here. Is that Mother Irene? Is that the wife of the late patriarch? I think that's Mother Irene. It's good to have her out today.
Yeah. I do hope that when the pictures have all been taken, that the camera lady is able to get in there with a nice close-up so that the bride and groom can greet all the viewers.
Yes, please. I hope that, yes. So if she can go to Brother Kurt, if she can go to Pastor Kurt right now, I say, Pastor Kurt, the people online would just like to get a nice photo of you and your wife. That would be great right now.
Yeah, they can pull some screenshots while we take a spill.
Yes, she goes.
I'm loving our camera lady on site. Excellent job.
We want to thank her for this job that she's doing. Roman service is what we're getting, you know.
Wonderful.
Can our camera lady go directly to the bride and then as we welcome the bride?
Your eyes, yes.
Yes, she does. I do apologize. I know we had a late summary of our script. there we go. There she goes, a little up. Look at Pastor Chris trying to play young boy.
Oh boy.
Okay, there she goes. If she didn't go directly, go up that. If she didn't go directly to the bride, go to the bride and let's say hi first.
Oh, there's more people taking pictures. I can imagine that the line is long.
I know. I can understand.
I can understand that.
Oh, look at that.
Isaiah Temple, you guys have come out well-dressed today. Go ahead with your bad self.
Oh, my goodness. I think that person is Mother Valerie. I may be wrong, but it looks like that's Mother Valerie. It looks like Mother Valerie.
I love it. All the colors, very elegant.
I see Sister Denise Berkeley's on.
And all these pictures with the mask. What's going to be funny, Bishop, is that in a couple of years down the road, they may not know who was in the picture.
Unless they know the eyes, you know, say all these masks.
Unnecessary precaution, but it's going to make really interesting look at the photo albums years from now.
Yes, it's really nice. But you know, safety first. I believe safety first. You know, COVID is still here. We want to encourage those of you who are watching. Please wear your mask. Please get vaccinated. Please be safe out there. You know, just be safe.
Numbers are rising.
Yes, it is. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as we get a little closer, here we have, can we get Kurt? I can't, oh my goodness, we can't get a moment for him.
We can't even, my goodness, he's on the move. But you know what, I'm pretty sure that he's going to have to come back for his wife at some point.
You know what, yeah, so there he is.
That Crimer woman is following.
More photos of the gentleman. And that is the father. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you for viewing this wonderful wedding ceremony of the Right Reverend Kurt and Mrs. Gaspar, Carla Gaspar, and just present time, who have now entered into the walk of oneness, no longer two, but two shall become one.
That's right.
God had to put Adam to sleep to take out the river and place him to create woman. Now he has his missing river, as he would say.
He found his rib and he secured it back. I love it, because you know how that does put out for function.
Make sure that
after all the picture taking, you get a good look of the venue for the reception, just to get a little view and let the viewers feel like they were there and invited to sit at the cameraman is busy at work.
Somebody said that this is a real Royal Baptist wedding. Oh my God. He's not even his wife out of sight. That's a good start. Look at that.
That's a very good start.
Standing
there. We're doing great.
Even the camera lady could just go and ask them to just address the audience here. We would be great. I know everybody's trying to get a picture.
Yeah, and it looks to be really great weather out there as well, Bishop. Sun is shining. Nobody's overly sweating. That means it's not too hot.
It is awesome weather in Trinidad and Tobago, you know, this time of year. Yeah, it is really awesome. You know, it's not like here in the United States, where you got cold weather in New York, I get bipolar weather in Texas.
It's definitely cold. It's
definitely cold. Yeah, it's bipolar here. You know, it's hot right now. It's going to get that cold this weekend.
This is true.
Yeah, so we will be ending our broadcast soon, ladies and gentlemen. We want to thank each and every one of you. Hopefully we do get a shot with the both of them together before we close out this broadcast.
We really would like to get a shot of them and also of them.
If I could leave this.
Yeah, we want to get a shot of the two of them at least to address and close off
this broadcast.
Yeah, that would be really wonderful.
Yes.
That would be wonderful.
Okay. Could our camera lady just go directly to them and ask them if they can address us, please?
Yeah, it's just such a long line of people wanting to take photos. I can imagine. You know, they're like the celebrity couple for today. So.
They are the celebrity couples for today. Yeah. Don't let them pass. Okay. Oh, there he is. Reverend Kirk. Oh, he's still taking pictures. Oh, my God.
More pictures. It's lovely, though. I'm really happy for the two of them.
Okay. There he is. I think he got it. Okay. Wow. I know it's a busy time for the day, ladies. There he is, ladies and gentlemen. The man of the hour, the one and only Pastor Kirk. How are you today?
I am blessed.
Pastor Kirk, you got 120 viewers watching you today, to you and your beloved wife. Where is your wife? We want you to address the crowd with your wife. We want to address the crowd of your wives before we bring this stream into a close.
Okay, give me a second. I'm going to put on my accent.
Go ahead and put on your accent.
Just don't put on a cola.
They're taking a little bit of pictures at the moment.
Okay. So, whilst you're waiting for her to get free, Rev Kurt, whilst you're waiting for her to get free, how did you feel when Sister Carla was walking down the aisle?
Just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, at home, we do apologize for the footage. There we go. We should be back. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back as they get situated there. We gotta get them there. Oh, there they are. Let's bring them in.
Oh,
and there they are, ladies and gentlemen, a beautiful couple, Mr. and Mrs. Gaspar. Listen, no more two, but one. Look at that. How does it feel to be Mr. and Mrs.?
Like a dream come true, happiest day of my life.
Nice.
Oh my God. Listen, did you hear that? A happiest day of his life. She feel excellent. Oh my God, listen. Please don't eat all the curry goat and roti there and go set some for us. Please.
Well, any
last words for your viewers before we close off this hour?
I want to say thank you to all of you who came out to view us. It indeed is a real special moment for us. It has been a long, long journey with a lot of ups and downs, a lot of praying, a lot of crying, a lot. But we thankful to God because we have always placed God as the foundation of this relationship in spite of what we have been said wherever. We have always placed God as the foundation of this relationship. And we have always placed the relationship in God's hand, and we depend only on God for the success and the longevity of our relationship. We thank each and every one of you who came out, all of my loyal Facebook family. I know Mother Juliana Nathaniel is looking on. I know Mother Marla Villafana, Crystal Diamond, the youth brother Raheem Bain, the Emmanuel Deliverance Temple Ministry, St. Michael's Ministry. Everyone, all well wishers, Dennis Guy, what in? For everyone, if I may not have remembered your name, we thank you for supporting us.
Well, you know, before you go,
me and my wife and I.
All right, but before you go, let me Pastor Jen say something, and then I will say my final. Then we gonna. So Pastor Jen, you want to go?
Well, first of all, thank you for
my wife and I.
Yeah, go ahead, your wife and you, go ahead and practice, man, practice. I just want to say on behalf of 123 viewers that we are so happy that you've allowed us into your wedding today. To be there and to share this moment with both of you. Some of the comments we're receiving online, amazing. I just want to let Sister Carla know, people say your makeup is on point, honey. Hunt. Okay, you on point. You really look gorgeous. God bless you. Our Reverend Kurt, you're looking quite dapper today. Somebody said they really
want a
bow tie. Okay, so go ahead with y'all bad self. The Gaspards are on the scene. They represented. God bless the two of you, and may your marriage be able to weather every storm. Marriage is not an easy thing. It is about the longevity. It's not just about the day. It is about the longevity of the relationship that comes after. And I pray that God bless you all mightily, and make his face to shine upon you in Jesus' name. God bless.
You know, great. So I
look out for us tonight. We have a surprise for everyone.
All right, God, thanks for having you here. So as let me just tell Pastor Kurt and to the new evangelist, Mrs. Pastor.
Mrs. Preacher.
We want to thank you. We want to thank you for allowing us to be in your wedding, for this exclusive right for it to be broadcast on Bishop Sheldon page. You and I go way back, but as I told Pastor Jen, you just don't have friends, but you have people you can call when you need some advice. You have people you can call that when you want to talk about something. Let me you know that our relationship, this relationship is not three, but two. So if you both of y'all can't work it out, the only thing you can do is to go hear somebody else. But at the end of the day, the both of y'all must sit down and work it out together. Because when you stood before the altar, was two of y'all and God. I pray God that to bless this wedding, bless this marriage. As Pastor Jen said, it is the longevity. You're going to have some hills to climb. You're going to have some valleys to go through. But if you go through it with Christ, you will overcome. Again, blessing, congratulations, and it has been an honor. Be blessed. All right. So, saints of God, as we get over here in the name of Jesus, let's take this over here in the name of Jesus. I think they just cut our feet over there. And let's bring it over here. And are we on? Nice. Pastor Jen, how are you doing? Listen, it has been an honor with them today. It really has been an honor co-hosting this wedding with you. Milford Pompey just joined us, part of Wellcock. I'm happy for them. I'm really, really, truly, truly happy for them. And I pray that everybody who was here would say an extra prayer for them in the midst of COVID and in the midst of grief. They still decide to go through. And, you know, I want to let them know that the joy of the Lord is their strength. And I know that his spiritual father, the great patriarch, Stephen Julian is would have been happy to see this day, but God has called him from work to reward and has allowed them now to live this joy in Notre Dame. And again, to the youth of viewers, it has been a pleasure having you here. Let me let Pastor Jen have the last word as we bring our broadcast to a close.
You know, we just want to bless them. We want to bless the two of them for this opportunity to share, to be a part of this day. And we want to thank all the viewers that came on and spent this time with us. So celebrate. And as you're celebrating their union, remember to pray them up. They need your prayers so that they can make it to the long haul. Bishop, thank you for allowing me the privilege of co-hosting. I thank Preacher Preach for requesting, for co-hosting. And have a beautiful afternoon.
All right, saints of God, it has been a pleasure. This is Pastor Jed and Bishop Sheldon signing off today. Thank you for joining us. Lord, turn face to our